Today we are going to start with exercise 4.5 of chapter 4, playing with numbers, maths. We are going to do the first 6 questions of this exercise. The rest of the questions will be completed in the next video. So the first question here they have given is, find the LCM of the given numbers by prime factorization method. Here PF means prime factorization method. First question is 28 and 98. So the prime factorization of 28 is 2 14s are 28, 2 7s are 14 and 7 1s are 7. So 2 and 7 are the prime factors. 2 into 2 into 7 are the prime factors of 28. Similarly, when we do the prime factorization of 98, we will get the prime factors as 2 into 7 into 7. Now, here 2 is repeated maximum 2 times. In LCM, we have to see a number should be repeated maximum times. We have to multiply that time. So, 2 is repeated maximum times 2 times. So, we will write 2 into 2 and 7 is also repeated maximum 2 times. So we write 7 into 7. So 2 into 2 into 7 into 7 is equals to 196. So 196 is the LCM of 28 and 98. Second, 24, 28 and 196. When we do the prime factorization of 24, we will get the prime factors as 2 into 2 into 3 into 2. Now, the prime factorization of 28. As earlier we have done it, so 2 into 2 into 7. This is the prime factors of 28. And 196. Prime factors of 196 here are 2 into 2 into 7 into 7. So, as earlier I have said, a number should be repeated maximum times. That times we have to write. So, 2 is repeated maximum 3 times. 2 is repeated maximum 3 times. So we will write 2 into 2 into 3. 2 into 2 into 2. And 3 here is repeated single. It's single. There is no repetition of 3 over here in the prime factors. So we will simply write 3 into. Now 7 is repeated maximum 2 times. So we'll write 7 into 7. So to find LCM, multiply all these prime factors. 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 7 into 7 is equals to 1176. So 1176 is the LCM of 24, 28 and 196. Now, the second question. Find the LCM of the given numbers by division method. So, we have to find the LCM of the following numbers by division method. First question is 480 and 672. When we find by the division method, it is easy as when we divide 480 and 672 by 2, we will get 240 and 336. And we will do it simultaneously, and as we do it until we get 1 as last, at last, then we have got the answer. We have to do it and then we will get the prime factors over here, the division method. So the prime factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 7, and the LCM of these prime factors is now 3360. So 3360 is the LCM of 480 and 672 from division method. Now second question is 24, 40 and 84. So the division method over here, it's given 2 divided by 24, 40 and 84, 12, 20 and 42. And similarly, when we do all these, when we get all the prime factors, then we have to just multiply all the prime factors and we'll get the answer as 840. So 840 is the LCM of 24, 40 and 84. Now the question 3. Find the least number which when increased by 15 is exactly divisible by 15, 35 and 48. We have to find the least number which is increased by 15. It is exactly divisible by 15, 35 and 48. So first, for the getting the answer of this question, first we have to find the LCM of 15, 35 and 48. The LCM over here is here. It will be 1680. Either we can use division method or we can use PF method over here or prime factorization method to find the LCM of 15, 35 and 48. It's our choice because they are not mentioned over here. So the LCM over here is 1680. And in order to find the required number, they have said that which when increased by 15. Remember that when it is written like this, it means that we have to subtract the LCM of these three numbers. When we subtract, we will get 1665 as the required number. So 1665 is the least number which when increased by 15 is exactly divisible by 15, 35 and 48. Now we are going to do the fourth question. The fourth question is, find the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves remainder 5 in each case. So we have to find the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves remainder 5 in each case. So now LCM of 6, 15 and 18. First we have to find the LCM of 6, 15 and 18. We will get the LCM as 90. Now, here also it's our choice. Either we can use the division method to find the LCM or we can use the prime factorization method. But the division method is easy, so I'm doing this division method. So, the LCM of 6, 15 and 18 will be 90. And in order to find the required number, here they have said that find the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves a remainder 5 in each case. It leaves a remainder 5. So here we'll just add 90 and 5. We'll get the answer as 95. So 95 is the least number which when divided by 6, 15 and 18 leaves remainder 5 in each case. Now, question 5. Find the least number which when divided by 24, 36, 45 and 54 leaves the remainder of 3 in each case. So there was, we have to find the least number which when divided by 24, 36, 45 and 54 leaves the remainder 3 in each case. So first, as the previous one, it is simple. LCM of 24, 36, 45 and 54. We have to find the LCM. We will get the LCM as 1080. Now in order to find, as the previous one, we have added 90 and 5. We will add here 1080 plus 3. So the answer here will be 1083, which is the required number. So 1083 is the least number which when divided by 24, 36, 45 and 54 leaves a remainder of 3 in each case. Now question 6. Find the greatest 3 digit number which is exactly divisible by 8, 20 and 24. So we have to find the greatest 3 digit number which is exactly divisible by 8, 20 and 24. First, find the LCM of 8, 20 and 24. LCM of 8, 20 20 and 24 after obtaining the prime factors, we get as 120. So 120 is the LCM of these three numbers. Here also you can use prime factorization or division method. Now for finding the answer of this question, you have to just see which is the greatest three digit number. So the greatest three digit number is 999, and now we have to divide 120 and 999. We have to just divide, we don't have to find the HCF, we have to find the division. We have to divide 120 and 999, and here when we divide it, we get the quotient as 8 and the remainder as 39. And now, in order to find the answer, here required number is equal to 999 should be subtracted from the remainder. Remainder is 39. So 999 minus 39 is equal to 960. So 960 is the greatest three digit number, which is exactly divisible by 8, 20 and 24.